Hey folks, in today's tutorial we are going to build a medical assistant chatbot using Power Virtual Agent, Microsoft Teams, and Azure OpenAI. As you can see here from this demo, we are asking our medical assistant chatbot a question about our physical health. Then the bot will answer, providing suggestions on what you should do. With that being said, let's actually switch gears and go to the Azure portal to get started. In the Azure portal, look for OpenAI. And once you find it in the marketplace, select and press create. One thing that I want to note here when is that OpenAI requires you to submit a form. So basically, I'll leave the application down in the description below if you would like to follow through with us. Here we are just choosing the name for our resource. And then also I selected the resource group that it's going to be in. In a network, I'm just going to go with the default. Let's actually go to the review and submit. While this is deploying, we are going to uncover the tool that will allow us to build this chatbot, which is the Power Virtual Agent. So let's switch context to that. In Teams, you can look for Power Virtual Agent. I already have it open, as you can see in the background, but you can look for it in your apps. I also pinned it to my left pane. You can do the same thing. Now in Power Virtual Agent, let's actually select chatbots and press on new chatbot. We are given the option to choose where we are going to add this chatbot, and we are going with the retail channel. So I'm going to only add it to the retail channel. I don't want to add it to multiple channels. Obviously, you could do that if you'd like. Now we are provided with a GUI where we are asked to enter a name for our chatbot. I'm going with something generic, which is my medical assistant. We can also choose the language that is supported by the bot. The English is the default, so we're going to leave it as such and press create. The bot will take a few minutes to actually be provisioned. So let's switch back to our Azure portal and check on our deployment. We can see that our deployment is done. And if we select resource management and our keys and endpoints, we see our endpoint and our two keys. So let's now introduce a new tool, which is the Azure AI. In the Azure AI Studio, we are going to switch to our subscription and select our resource that we just deployed. You can see that we have multiple tabs to choose from. We are going to focus in two. The first is the deployment and the second is the chat. In the deployment, we select our model that we want to deploy, it's GPT-35 Turbo, and then we have to just give it a name. So this is our ChatGPT bot, basically, that we will be using. Once this is deployed, we are going to go. So as you can see here from the chat, like we have different templates. So we have one for Xbox support, customer support agent, another one for IRS. We are just going to use the default, and we're going to ask, just a generic question, what's the latest in React, and we have the bot answer that question. Now that's done, let's actually go back to Power Virtual Agent, select topics, and let's create a new topic from blank. Here we are going to choose a trigger phrase. This is our starting point to start interacting with our chatbot. So our trigger phrase here is I need some help. And then the next step, like it was given for us, a message. We delete that, go with a different action, which is a question. Here, like we want our bot to ask us, how can I help you? And choose the for identifier or identify, right? We choose the entire user response. We are going to save this user response as a variable in a variable called user input. And then we're going to call an action, a different action, which is create flow action. It's a Power Automate flow. And this is where we are going to use Azure OpenAI to answer our question. So select Power Virtual Agent. And for the user input, we are going to have user input for input, sorry, we put user input and user input here. And then this is basically just taking on what the user input from that response, from that question, how can I help you? When we pass in it to the Power Automate flow. So here we are also adding an HTTP request to make the request to our OpenAI instance that we created in Azure. So here, as you can see, this is like, you know, we have different code samples. I'm going to with curl because it's easy to see like the HTTP URL and so on. So we copy the URL and then paste it there. We are also going to need the API key, right? Which is those keys that we saw earlier when we created our Azure OpenAI instance. So with these two things done, now we are ready to just pass in the body. So to do that, just go back to the sample code, and then we are going just to copy and paste the entire object. So, and then and we are going to paste it into the body as you imagined, right? Here we are going to tweak it a little bit. So the first thing that we will be doing is to tell the system prompt that it is. So let's delete first, sorry, the surplus. But then we are going to tell the system prompt that this is a medical chatbot and nothing else. So like, you know, give information about like, you know, medical information and that's it. This is, will narrow the scope. So if you ask it about technology or anything else or politics, this bot will not answer those questions. And then for the user input, right? Like, or for that user question, we don't want to be hard coded. So we delete that and then select the user input as you saw just now. So now let's actually add a new action, which is parse JSON. So what this action will do, like it will take the response that we are getting back from OpenAI and basically generate a schema for it. So then we can actually store those answers in a variable. And as you can see here, like it should tell you to choose the content and the schema. So we are gonna introduce a tool here, it's Postman. I'm gonna make a generic call to OpenAI using our instance that we just created here. And this is just to actually get the body payload from the response, or the response payload from OpenAI. So I copy it and going back to our step in Power Virtual Agent, or this is a Power Automate flow, copying this so we can say generate from sample. And then when we paste it, this will actually generate the schema of our response that we will be getting from OpenAI. This is the one of the last steps. Once now that we parse our response from OpenAI, we are gonna have to save it into a variable so we can pass it back to our Power Virtual Agent. And this is like where we look for initialize variable action. And here we gotta give it a name, so response value, and instead of it being a boolean, it's gonna be a string. Let's rename it and give it a name that's meaningful. So first answer, or like you can just say answer. I don't know why you called it first answer. And then here I'm leaving the expression that I'm typing, because like it took me a while to get it right, down in the description below of this video. So you can actually just copy it and paste it, and you don't have to struggle through it as you see me do here. But once this is done, once like you get the first answer, like to save, like you can save the expression, we are gonna return that variable to our Power Virtual Agent. So here you can just say first answer as the variable, and then select the response value from, like, you know, the step, the prior step. You save it, and then let's actually go back to our virtual agent. So once you save it, you can quit out of this, or you can actually, like, you know, go back to Power Virtual Agent. In the Power Virtual Agent, there is like there is this flow that you can select here, and then for it, like you just select for like the variable, you can say user input. As you can see here, the Power Automate returns a first answer response, and this is the last step where we say done, or we can have a custom custom message. I chose to go with the custom message. Honestly, you can just like if you'd like, you can return first answer and you're good. But here I'm saying here is what I found, and then paste in basically the answer, or like selecting the answer that's coming back from OpenAI. To end the flow here, I'd like to end it always with a survey to make sure that you know, we met the threshold that the user expects from our bot. So you save it and you press test on the right, on the top right corner. And here, let's actually test our bot. So you can say, I need some help. The bot will reply, how can I help you? Then we are going to ask it a question about our physical health. This question, then it will actually trigger our Power Automate flow. And Power Automate, as you saw, it takes that user input, it goes and it makes an HTTP request to Azure OpenAI, which then we are going to parse and then save into a variable. And that variable will pass back to our Power Virtual Agent so it can answer this question that we asked. This is very seamless. As you can see, it's very straightforward. Once everything works, like there is a survey and like you're good to go. So in our last step here, what we are gonna do to make this available is the publish step. So now we are going to press the publish tab. There is a publish button where you can just press publish, and that this, believe it or not, we'll make it available for you to use. And then here you can see in the green banner that there, like, you know, our app is ready to use. So you can press on the three dots or the ellipsis and look for your app. So once you find it, you can press on it or click on it. You can interact with it directly, right, as a user, as you normally interact with a user in Microsoft Teams. And here we are just gonna ask it a question, right? And basically, like, we start with our trigger phrase, which is, I need some help. The bot will ask you, how can I help you? And then we're gonna go through the same motions of what we saw with the bot when we tested the bot. So this is basically our 360 view of like how you can build a bot with Power Virtual Agent, Microsoft Teams, and Azure OpenAI. Thank you.